As I recall, one day in 832, when we were returning north from Northumbria, driving stolen cattle, we had taught the Northumbrians a lesson for their raids on Alba and on Galloway. The cattle were our booty and part of our revenge. Now we found ourselves north of the Lothian Tyne, faced with a reversal of our fortunes. Our enemies had caught up with us. Saxons, also raiding the Northumbrian Angles under a chieftain, Athelstan, and now following us and the cattle. Athelstan, a name you will remember, for this is the story of Athelstaneford. I was a young man then, much the same age as Kenneth, the young Prince of Galloway, whose grandfather was one of two kings, Uche of Scots Dalriada, and Angus MacFergus, High King of Pictish Alba, who were leading us. I followed Kenneth and his troop, rather than the two old kings, because of his spirited impatience with the wise old heads. He had the arrogance of youth, but also authority. The authority of a wise head on young shoulders. I followed him gladly on our raid south into Northumbria, and back, and would have followed him to the death. Almost did. But he was our saviour in a battle which became a myth, and a symbol in Scotland forever. Kenneth knew the dangers that lay in the way when the two kings decided to take their men and the cattle into the morass of the Pepper Valley. But his advice was dismissed as the ramblings of a can of youth. We, a scouting party on the ridge between Tyne and Pepper, could see it all beginning to happen. Our kilted army leading the straggling cattle towards the ford at Prora. There could be no hurry. Then the enemy. They were many and getting closer, with a new and greater danger. Athelstan had divided his forces. As one section followed our retreating Gallic horsemen and cattle, another section was heading up the Tyne Valley, obviously intending to encircle us from the west and to grasp us in a mailed fist. Kenneth decided quickly what we and his small troop must do. We rode at speed to another narrow crossing on the Pepper. We did what we could to obstruct the ford in the short time we had. All we found to hand were stunted hawthorn trees, which we dragged onto the ford to make a barrier. Then they came. 800 against our 40. Their first onslaught failed, and we would have stood more, but that they had found another crossing place and were already on our flank. Kenneth knew that our main body of men was in conflict behind us. He turned us to give what help we could in battle there. We wheeled and drove like a wedge through the melee of men, horses and cattle, and our speed carried us through the confusion to the two kings surrounded on the hill. It appeared that all was lost. Were we to perish there? As we turned to face the battlefield, everyone around us was looking upwards. Why were they all looking at the sky? A strange sky. A white cross of cloud against the blue. And then the cry of our Gallic men. Surrender! It was a sign. It gave us new heart. Kenneth rallied us. In an inspired charge, he led us through the crowd of struggling men when Athelstan, in pursuit of victory, was closing on the two kings. We swept on, amazed by our rising strength. So, it was all over. Athelstan fell, and with him died the heart of the Saxon forces. So the day was ours. You will remember that day always, as I do, when you see the Saltire of Athelstaneford. In the years that followed, the Picts and the Scots grew closer and united as one nation under a common flag, the Scottish Saltire, as you know it today.